This chapter is about creating and consuming TypeScript modules. In this chapter, we will learn about TypeScript modules. We will see the features of the modules. We have a fully functional app without using modules already in the previous chapter. So why modules? I'll tell you why here. Now, all the browsers do not support module. To work for this, we will also see some supporting technologies to use modules in TypeScript application. We will then use the modules in our app by importing and exporting them. We will wrap up the chapter with the explanation of how TypeScript resolves the location of the modules that we import. So let's start with the reason why we use modules. We have already created a working app in the previous chapter without using modules. So why now? Well, for a small project like ours, it will not make much of a difference. But when we work with large ones, modules are really helpful. We can use the modules to encapsulate the implement details and only expose the required API we want the other modules to consume. This allows us to refactor our code in the module independent of the modules that consume the API and vice versa. So we can refactor the code in module A independent of these modules, and we can modify these modules independent of module A. And this remains true as far as this API doesn't change. Now, modules can be designed to implement a specific functionality. Hence, can be referred to as large building blocks in our app. This way, the modules become reusable. We can use it as needed in different parts of our app, as well as let other apps use it as they want. The support for modules in JavaScript first came up with the ECMA 2015 version. Before that, developers used the popular non-native formats with browsers and node applications. However, with TypeScript, we can write the modules using the built-in syntax and run it through the TypeScript compiler. For this code to be supported with older applications or runtime environment that do not support native modules yet, we will have to use some supporting technologies. We use the module compiler option to specify which JavaScript module format our compiler should output. TypeScript uses the ECMA 2015 module syntax, but using the module option, we can have the compiler output AMD, CommonJS, UMD, or system modules along with the ES2015 format. Node natively loads the CommonJS modules, but if we are writing a browser app, we might have to use the required JS or system.js libraries to load modules. Another option is to use a module bundler like Webpack. This will prepare the modules to execute in a browser as a part of a build step. In our demo app, we will use Webpack. Now let us move on to the syntax required to use modules in TypeScript.